What is going on YouTube? Welcome back to another one of my videos. In today's video, we're gonna be covering some Fisherman beanies. Now, a lot of you have been asking me to do a second video. I made one last year where I covered some of the beanies that I had previously added onto my collection. So I thought I'll do a second video just covering everything with regards to beanies, with regards to sizing, where to purchase them, how to wear them. So I'm gonna be covering all of that into today's video. So stay tuned and let's hop right into it. First and foremost, most of my beanies, I purchased them from Raised by Society. This one is actually not even mine. But these are my new ones, these three, including this off-white one. This one was gifted to me after they saw my video, so shout out to Raised by Society. This is not a sponsored video. I randomly came across them last year or back in 2019 or 18, and before that I was mostly kind of buying my beanies all over the place, like just your fast fashion retailers like Topman, Zara here and there, but mostly Topman, ASOS. And I think when I was in London, I purchased one from a Weekday. I'll show it to you guys one sec. It was this one. This one, I purchased it from Weekday, one size fits all. And it's been quite useful. And I actually find it quite, in terms of fabric and quality, I find it a bit more durable than these Raised by Society ones, which are a little bit softer. Therefore, I'm kind of able to wear these a bit more, like when it starts getting a little bit warm and I kind of still want to wear a beanie. I'm able to wear these Raised by Society ones, but not this Weekday one because this one is actually quite warm, to be honest. But yeah, anyway, so just to quickly cover the three new ones that I picked up. So we have the red one. Now, the reason why I bought a red one is I previously had a cashmere one from Club Monaco that I kept for about like a good 4 years, to be honest, and I would always utilize it with my outfits, and I thought it was just such a good way to break away from my all black looks that I usually wear. I bought a new one and it's been perfect. It fits really well with my wardrobe. It's just such a good color. Red is always such a vibrant good color, especially in the winter, because I find that, like, because in the winter I generally don't tend to dress up that much. I just kind of put like a black coat, some black pants, some black boots. Red is always a good accessory to have, like a red nice beanie. I find it works perfectly for me. And then I added two more colors, the brown one, which I previously didn't have any beanies in brown. So I thought, you know what, I'm gonna give it a try and see how it goes with my outfit. And it's been absolutely perfect. It's been great. I love having this one in my wardrobe. I've been utilizing it quite a lot with some of my outfit. It makes me kind of step away from all the other colors and not necessarily have to wear the same old colors like military green, white, or like black. So the brown one has been quite useful. And then we have this last one that I'm wearing here, which is the off-white colorway. Now this one, I haven't utilized it as much. I don't know why. Maybe it's because I have way too many beanies right now, but I haven't been getting a lot of use out of this one. But either way, fits absolutely great. It's a good color as well, I find, especially if I'm like in the spring, if I'm looking to wear like an all-white look, this off-white color could be a nice accessory touch. So we'll see, still kind of playing around with it. So yeah, with regards to colors, I'll definitely say, look, buy as much as you want, you know, but also sort of find what works for you. If military green is your color, just buy a variety of them and utilize them with your style and see how it goes. For me personally, I find all of the colors work pretty well, and I'm usually pretty good with just sort of knowing what to combine my outfit with which color. So if you can utilize beanies, colorful beanies into your outfit, you definitely elevate a look. So yeah, so now we're gonna hop right into sizing. So with regards to sizing, now for the Fisherman beanies in particular, honestly, most of them come in one size fits all. Now that's the thing with beanies, right? Like the reason why I say that, like it's so difficult for me to be specific on which ones to buy, just because like everyone has a different head shape and everything fits differently on everyone. And that's why I highly encourage you guys to just kind of give every type of beanie a try and see what works for you and what doesn't work for you. Like, yes, you can be inspired, but I would highly suggest for you to kind of like play around with different type of shapes of beanies and figure out what works for you. Like, and this brings me on to sizing, because for example, most of my beanies are one size fits all, like I said, but there are some beanies where they will give you a size 1 or size 2, just like a smaller version and a bigger version, I guess. But for the most part, I usually tend to go to a one size fits all. These two ones, like this one doesn't even have, this is the Raised by Society one that was gifted, and this one doesn't even have any sizing on it, you know. So I would actually, one sec. Yeah, it has no sizing on it, so this probably would be just a one size fits all. It fits a bit bigger. It's not necessarily a fisherman beanie, but can be worn like a fisherman beanie if you just kind of roll it and play around with it a little bit. And then this one from Noah is also a one size fits all, but much bigger, covers your ears. And these ones, these two ones, I tend to wear them when it's a little bit too cold. And I kind of want to cover my ears, I'll usually go for these ones. This one, I actually use it to work out and for my runs, and it's been quite useful just because every now and then I can kind of do this, and then it fits a little bit longer, covers my ears pretty well, and it's warm. So this one, I definitely utilize it a lot more during the winter, and it's an absolutely perfect beanie. It's kept its shape. It's really good quality as well, actually. Which I really like, but yeah, so one size fits all once again. So that's pretty much it on sizing, honestly. Like, a lot of the beanies that you will find will be a one size fits all, so it's up to you to try it on. Like, I would highly suggest for you, like, if you go in store once things open up, to always try beanies before buying them. I know most of us shop online now, but yeah, if you ever are in a store and need to purchase a beanie, definitely suggest for you to try them on, because even when they say one size fits all, a lot of them fit differently. Like, I could tell you that, like, even the Raised by Society ones that I have, they all kind of fit differently. Like, one black one might fit better than the other black one. So yeah. So now to conclude the video, we're gonna talk about versatility. Now, with regards to fisherman beanies, in terms of versatility, I'll say just find different colors. Find different colors, try them all, see what works, see what doesn't work, and I promise you, it is such a good way to elevate a look. Especially, like I mentioned, if you are someone that tends to wear all black colors or all neutral sort of colors, beanies will definitely accentuate a look and will make it look a bit more neat and a bit more sort of stylish in a way. So that's what I tend to do for me. I have a bunch of colors, as you can see. I have the orange, the yellow, the military green, the blue, and I use these all the time, especially now that we're in quarantine and you can't get a haircut. I am mostly wearing a beanie, like I am now. In most of my videos, I wear my beanies. In most of my outfit pictures, I'm wearing my beanies. And usually, I'm always in beanies in the winter because it just gets ridiculously cold here. Another thing that I can actually suggest is, another thing that I can actually suggest is to have these bigger ones as well. They could definitely be useful in some of your outfits. They can kind of be a different way to style a beanie, and as well, they're a bit warmer than the fisherman beanies because most of the fisherman beanies don't cover your ears. This is just the versatility, like trying different beanies, trying to figure out what works for you. Fortunately for me, I find that most of them that I wear do work in terms of my style, in terms of how I like to dress. That's why I usually utilize them quite a lot. And actually, every beginning of the year or every winter, I usually purchase a new black clean one. I didn't this year. I'll show you the two black ones that I have. So I have this one and this one. And as you can see, the bad thing about wearing beanies too much is that it doesn't look as clean anymore. So these ones have definitely been utilized, as you can see. I'm still getting a lot of wear out of them, but I'm definitely gonna be copying some new ones come winter 2021. But my black beanies is something that I always invest in, just because I feel like a black beanie looks good with any outfit that you throw it on with. So that's pretty much it with regards to beanies. I gave you colors, sizing, versatility. I mostly purchase all of mine at Raised by Society. You can try it weekday, ASOS online, as well sells a couple beanies and just your fast fashion retailers. I hope this video helps you in finding the right beanie for you. Guys, if you enjoy your content, always make sure to subscribe. It helps me out a ton. As always, you can follow me on my Instagram, GREGNTORE, where you'll see outfit pictures. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you for watching. Peace out.